Thanks for tuning in, I'm Budget Nerd. Are you tired of running things over when you back up? Tired of getting sour looks when you can't parallel park? Are you tired of sleepless nights tossing and turning? Look no further than the Autovox Solar Wireless Reversing System. It's guaranteed to help with some of those things. Here on this channel, I'll pick it apart so you'll know whether to drop some coin on it or not. Meet the Autovox Solar Wireless Reversing System. Yes, that's a mouthful. And yes, they sent it over to check out. It's between 160 and 190, depending on your use of the Amazon coupon. It all comes in this slick box. You get some papers, the LCD screen that you'll mount on your windshield somewhere. It's about 5 1/4 inches wide by 3.5 inches tall. You can see there are a few buttons for pushing, an antenna, and the cable you use to connect it to power. Below that, you can see the license plate bracket with its camera on top, and the solar panel and battery in the base. It's made of metal and plastic and feels tough. In this box, you get the USB plug for charging the battery anytime it's not sitting in the sun or hasn't been in use for a while. The suction cup mount, which is also sticky. This thing, probably meant to help remove the suction cup at a later date or to open this little door to charge the battery when the sun won't cut it. And of course, the cigarette power adapter. They claim it only takes a few minutes to install, and that's true. If you're going to be a perfectionist where you place the screen and want to take a while routing your cable, then it will take longer. But just to get it set up, it's super quick. Remove your license plate, slide it in the bracket, and then screw it back on. It's that simple. They do recommend you charge the camera with the USB cable before first use, but I didn't, because they're not the boss of me. Pull off the cover from the suction cup, place it where you want it, mount the screen, angle it how you want, and then tighten the nut. Then plug it in and route your cable if you want. It's also easy. The screen doesn't have a battery. It'll need to be plugged in to be used. The idea behind this is the camera is always on and broadcasting as long as it's able to charge with the sun, and when power is applied to the screen or when you push this button, it will come on and show you what the camera sees. It should come on for the preset time automatically when you turn your car on. After that, if you want it, press the button. If your car always provides power, even when turning the car on, you'll find yourself always pushing the button to turn the screen on. You get the option to change the lines on the screen, and depending on the camera angle, you can loosen the two screws that hold the camera in place and adjust it. With these two adjustments, you might find a set of lines that could work for you. I couldn't find any that were close, but that was just my experience. Back to the screen. In the upper right, you can see the battery level for the camera. They claim the battery will last 2 months when full and can stay charged with only 30 minutes of sunlight per day. In the menu, you can see you have the options to pair the device, should it ever lose its connection, change the brightness, mirror the image, change the screen timeout length, change the lines, or reset all the settings. As far as usability, it's certainly not as nice or as ideal as some of the built-in systems in modern cars these days. If you're expecting to get that level of tech in an older car, you might not be happy with this. However, it does do what it says it'll do, and I never had any issues. They claim it uses frequency hopping, which would help with interference. I never had an issue with that. The screen's okay. It's not the brightest, and when you have the sun coming into your car at the right angle, it can be a bit hard to see. Also, with polarized glasses, it can appear even dimmer depending on how your head is tilted. Under most circumstances, the screen totally works. The screen's resolution seems a bit low, but it's within the realm of acceptable. This is only a real-time feed. This setup won't record or capture any video. I contacted my dad and had him put it on his 30-foot RV. He did have a bump for a bulb at the top of his license plate section that prevented us from mounting it for the time being. But we did want to test its range to see if the camera would transmit far enough for an RV, and it did. We temporarily rested the camera on his bumper for now, and hooked up the rest. Not a single issue. It worked at 30 feet, though they claim the max is 33 feet. I was surprised and happy about this. As far as long-term durability, it's tough to tell. All in all, it does what it says it will do, and I don't have any major issues with this. Aside from the few things we discussed that could be negatives for some people, it's not too bad. If the price seems right for you and you're interested, there's a link below. Thanks for watching.